Well, right now we don't know exactly what happened, but crews are still here. If you take a look behind me, you can see that they have brought in some lights. They're still making the effort to upright many of these rail cars. It's been a spectacle all day long, and still there's no answers as to what really caused it.
Freight cars off the tracks and flipped on their sides.
I didn't know it was a train. I thought something blew up. Is what I thought it was.
That loud?
It was that loud, yeah.
Quite a sound and quite a sight. It was shortly before 11 Tuesday morning. This freight train carrying coal derailed. Of the 87 cars in tow, 7 ran into trouble, 3 flipping and spilling their load, while the wheels of the other 4 simply came off the track. The dozens of cars ahead of the derailed ones were sent on their way, headed north to Merrimack Power Station in Bow.
They have a process that they'll go through where they'll be able to pull the other cars back up onto the track and slowly pull those back.
The deputy fire chief says he's not sure what caused the train to derail, and he wasn't able to talk to the engineer.
This happened over here. He was up on the Lock Street end of this incident, so I have not spoken to him.
The rail line is owned by Pan Am, and a spokesperson for the railway says the track is inspected weekly by federally licensed inspectors. Pan Am says it's too early to pinpoint the reason for the derailment. There is a black box on the locomotive, which the company hopes can give more insight.
Now, as of late this afternoon, Pan Am says that they have found no broken rails here on the site. As for the speed that the train was going, they don't really know, but they say that the standard is 10 miles per hour. Reporting live in Nashua, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.